Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I'll be decoding brick and mortar of a foreign policy written by Happimon Jacob. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial basically is about of how we can strengthen our foreign policy. This editorial is about what all back support is required in order to strengthen our foreign policy. Before we understand the paraphernalia, before we understand the wherewithal that is required for the foreign policy, we must understand the nature, the soul and the substance of the foreign policy. So what does the foreign policy stand for? What is meant by foreign policy? Foreign policy is all about competing with others. Foreign policy is all about making your needs addressed from a world community. Foreign policy is all about influencing the other. Foreign policy is all about engaging with the other diplomatically to get your needs addressed. So as far as the foreign policy of India is concerned, we have a cadre of about 1,000 people who are working in this domain. Now, as far as the present situation is concerned, the current scenario is concerned, it is a globalized milieu in which we are living. And in the globalized milieu, everything that a country does is dependent on the other countries. So, in order to make our needs addressed, we require on a continuous basis to maneuver the policies of the other countries. We manipulate our own policies, we manipulate and influence the policies of other countries so that the needs, our own needs are met. Now, as far as this editorial is concerned, this editorial talks about how we need to strengthen our cadre of IFS, foreign services, how we need to back up, how we need to take up the support of the backup from the scholars, from the think tanks and from the people who have a lot of experience in the foreign policy domain. Right now, as far as the foreign policy is concerned, it is a unidirectional, it is a unidirectional and unidimensional endeavor. So it is, what is meant by unidirectional and unidimensional endeavor? The foreign policy of India, it disengages itself from taking the support of other ministries. It thinks that the foreign policy is a very specialized domain. It thinks that there is no need of infusing professionalism in the foreign policy domain. So the staff that is providing support to the external ministry, that is providing support to the foreign ministry, they tend to negate, they tend to disregard the role of the think tank, of the specialists and of the research scholars who have a lot of experience about the foreign policy. Now take the case of China. If India wants to deal proactively with China, we need someone who should be actually guiding the foreign ministry and the external affairs ministry about the past of China, of how the China has been behaving in the past. because that will make us bit more ingenuous, that will make us bit more intelligible, and that will make us bit more proactive in chalking out the path when we go out to deal with China. Now there is also a case to increase the cadre strength of the IFS. The why that should be done, like I've already told you, that we are in a globalized milieu. The everything that India does is connected with the outer world. Be that the health sector of India, it is connected with the patent laws of the WTO. Be that the agriculture sector, it is related with the agreement on agriculture of WTO. Be that the climatic change, it is related with the UNFCCC. Be that the sports sector of India, it is related with the ICC. Be that India's engagement with SAARC, be that India's engagement with ASEAN, be that India's engagement with European Union, be that India's engagement with Middle East, be that India's engagement with Pakistan to sort out the diplomatic row, be that the India's engagement with Australia, New Zealand, or for that matter with any country. So because we have become globalized, there is a need to increase the cadre strength. So 1,000+ people are actually going in for negotiations, going in for discussions, going in for influencing the others for the matters that are really substantive. So because it is a competitive domain, this foreign policy, we need to create enriched human resource in it. We need to avail the services, and we need to shed away this unidirectional and unidimensional approach of foreign policy. There should be a lateral entry in this specialized domain of foreign policy from the environment ministries, from the commerce ministries, from the education ministry, from the health ministry, because at the end of the day, the foreign policy makers, they are actually dealing with something that really matters for these ministries. And these ministries, they have a professional experience. They are actually professionals about their domains. And they could easily talk and they could easily maneuver about these specific aspects. A foreign policy man may not be aware of the lacunas in the patent laws. So commerce ministry might be well placed to understand this thing. Now, with respect to the Civil Liability Nuclear Act, so a scientist, an environmentalist, and a person from the civil societal organization is more aware about the consequences if there will be a nuclear disaster. So in order to provide fillip, in order to enrich the minds of the foreign policy makers, support should be taken. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors, and you can also read more about this. I have uploaded it on brainiki.com, and you can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information of the classes, you can visit the websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you've liked this video, please click on the like button. Do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.